الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد حبت في الله from some of the major sins that we have to avoid and especially this is an admonition for newlyweds and especially those amongst the youth because often their excitement and their rugba and desire for one another is often much stronger in their youth. And the ability to control themselves is often a much more difficult thing to achieve. And one of the things that we have to avoid and is a major, major sin with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is having sexual intercourse during menstruation. When a woman is going through her period, to have relations is muharram. It is impermissible and it is a major sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنَ الْمُحِيدِ قُلْ هُوَ أَذٍ فَاعْتَزِلُوا النِّسَاءَ مِنْ فِي الْمَحِيدِ وَلَا تَقْرَبُهُنَّ حَتَّى إِلَى آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, they ask you concerning menstruation. Say, that is a harmful thing. Meaning harmful to have sexual intercourse during menstruation. Therefore, keep away from women during menses and go not unto them till they have purified themselves. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not shy regarding the truth. And that's why these sensitive matters must be made known and must be discussed in one context or another, that this is impermissible and it is a major sin. However, that does not mean that the husband and wife, as is in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, cannot enjoy one another in every other means that is permissible. Meaning, as long as there is nothing, not as long as the husband does not enter her during menstruation, nor does he ever sodomize going through the anus, then it is permissible for them to enjoy one another through other activities that are of sexual relationships by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the husband can enjoy his wife, the wife can enjoy her husband. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabi al-kareem, fi idha tataharna فَأْتُوهُنَّ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, and when they have purified themselves, then go in unto them, as Allah has ordained for you. Allah has made it permissible for you to enjoy one another. So when she becomes pure, then you can resume your regular sexual relationship. And this is a ni'mah min ni'amillah. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in a hadith, in Sahih Tirmidhi, in the hadith of Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever has intercourse with a menstruating woman, with a woman in her rectum, or goes to a fortune teller, has disbelieved in what was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In that hadith, we see it's a stern warning. It's a stern warning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to approach a woman, of course, during her menses, meaning having those relationships during menses or in the anus, or to go to a fortune teller. That these are all the major sins. These are all from the major sins, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam warned us against. And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to bless us with the halal and protect us from the haram and bless us with ilm al-nafi wa rizq al-tayyib wa amal al-mutaqabbil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.